In this video, we're talking about perhaps and maybe. This is a question that a student asked me. They asked me specifically about perhaps, but I thought this was a great time to show you maybe as well. Of course, I'm Jennifer from JForrestEnglish.com, and this channel is dedicated to helping you sound like a fluent, confident, natural English speaker. Now, before we go any further, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon so you're notified every time I post a new lesson. Now, let's dive in with this video. Let's talk about maybe and perhaps. Now, first of all, you need to know that these are adverbs. And we use both of them when we think that something is possible, but not 100% certain. Now, although they both mean the same thing, maybe is more casual in tone, it's more conversational. And perhaps is more formal, more academic. Maybe is more commonly used. Now, the other difference is the sentence structure. Maybe we can use this at the beginning of a sentence. So I could say, maybe I'll go to the party. Maybe I'll go to the party. So this is when it's possible I'll go to the party, but it's not 100% sure. So I'm between yes, I'll go to the party and no, I won't go to the party. I'm between them. Maybe I'll go to the party. Another example, let's say your friend says, have you seen my phone? And you could reply back and you could say, maybe you left it in the car. So here, your friend doesn't know 100% that you left it in the car. It's simply a possibility. Maybe you were just in the car a short while ago. Maybe you were just in the car. Again, it's not 100% certain, it's just a possibility. So your friend could say, maybe you left it in the car. And notice that placement, it's at the beginning of the sentence. Now, we can also use maybe as a one-word reply, which is very commonly used in conversations. So using our same example, your friend says, have you seen my phone? And then you could ask a question. You could say, did you leave it in the car? And then you could reply back and say, maybe, maybe. And of course, as a full sentence, that would be, maybe I left it in the car. It's possible, I don't know 100%, but it's possible. Maybe I left it in the car, or simply, maybe. Are you going to the party tonight? Maybe. Maybe I'll go to the party tonight. So remember, we have these two options for placement at the beginning of the sentence or as a one-word reply, which of course could be turned into a full sentence where maybe is at the beginning. Now let's take a look at some examples using perhaps. Perhaps it means the exact same thing, but remember, it's just more formal and is not as commonly used. There's one other difference. We can also use perhaps in the middle of a sentence as well. We can use it at the beginning, the middle, and also a one-word reply. So structurally, perhaps has more flexibility than maybe. Now, at the beginning of the sentence, I could say, perhaps I'll go to the party tonight. Perhaps I'll go to the party. Okay, same thing as maybe, just it does sound more formal to me when I hear perhaps. Maybe is more common. Again, as a one-word reply, are you going to the party tonight? Perhaps. Perhaps I'll go to the party tonight. Again, just a little more formal. Now, here's something we can do with perhaps that we can't do with maybe, and that's to use it in the middle of a sentence. And I could say, I'll perhaps go to the party tonight. I'll perhaps go to the party tonight. So if you wanted to use maybe in that case, you would just need to change the placement and put it at the beginning and say, maybe I'll go to the party tonight. To summarize, both maybe and perhaps have the same meaning as when something is possible but not 100%, We can use maybe at the beginning or as a one word reply. We can use perhaps at the beginning, the middle, and a one word reply. Maybe is more conversational, more commonly used, and perhaps is more formal. And now you know how to use maybe and perhaps. So of course, I want you to practice. So leave a comment and make sure you practice using maybe and perhaps. Now see if you can use perhaps in the middle of a sentence as well. Remember, that's only possible with perhaps. So put your examples in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and of course, subscribe. Now, before you go, make sure you head on over to my website, jforrestenglish.com, and download your free speaking guide. In this guide, I share 6 tips on how to speak English fluently and confidently. And until next time, happy studying. Awesome job! I can't wait to read your examples and see you using perhaps and maybe fluently and confidently. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!